Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will learn about the multistage amplifiers. So in the earlier videos, we have seen that how the BJT can be used as an amplifier in the different configurations. And in each configuration, the amplifier provides the finite voltage gain as well as finite input and the output impedance. But many times, this voltage gain may not be sufficient for the particular application. For example, if we want to amplify the 1 millivolt signal to the 1 volt, then we require the gain of the 1000. And the single amplifier will not be able to provide that. So in such case, we need to use the multistage amplifiers. So to increase the gain, when the multiple amplifiers are cascaded together, then it is known as the multistage amplifiers. Apart from that, for the impedance matching on the input or output side, we also need to go for the multistage amplifiers. And to understand it, first of all, let us see the effect of the source and the load resistance on the amplifier performance. And first of all, let us start with the effect of the source resistance. Now, so far in our discussion, we have assumed that the input which is applied to the amplifier has a zero source resistance. But actually, if you see, every source has some finite resistance. And because of the source resistance, the input signal which appears at the input of the amplifier will be less than the source signal. So to find the amplitude of this input signal, we can replace this amplifier by its input impedance. So now, this input voltage Vin will be equal to Zin divided by Zin plus Rs times Vs. And if we see the overall voltage gain, that is Vout divided by Vs, then it will be equal to Vout divided by Vin times Vin divided by Vs. That is equal to Zin divided by Zin plus Rs times AV. So as you can see, now the overall voltage gain or the effective voltage gain depends on the input as well as the source resistance. For example, let's say one amplifier provides the voltage gain of 100 and its input impedance is equal to 1 kilo ohm. Now if the source resistance Rs is few ohms, let's say it is equal to 10 ohm, then in that case, this overall voltage gain will be approximately equal to 100. But if the source resistance Rs is equal to 1 kilo ohm, then in that case, the effective voltage gain or the overall voltage gain will become 50. So as you can see, this source resistance can have a significant impact on the overall voltage gain of the amplifier. Similarly, when we connect the load to the amplifier, then it will also have an effect on the overall voltage gain. And to understand it, let us take the example of the common emitter amplifier. So we know that for the common emitter amplifier, the voltage gain can be given as minus GM times RC. And let's call this voltage gain as the no load voltage gain. Now when we connect the external load to this amplifier, then the voltage gain can be given as minus GM times RC parallel RL, right? That is equal to minus GM times RC times RL divided by RC plus RL. Now here, this minus GM times RC is nothing but the no load voltage gain, right? That means we can say that this overall voltage gain will be equal to this no load voltage gain times RL divided by RC plus RL. And if you are aware, then for the common emitter amplifier, this output impedance is equal to RC. That means we can say that the voltage gain will be equal to this no load voltage gain times RL divided by RL plus Z0. That is the output impedance. So this is the expression of the effective voltage gain when we connect the load to the amplifier. So here, if this load resistance RL is much greater than the output impedance, in that case, this overall voltage gain will be same as the no load voltage gain. But if this load resistance is comparable to the output impedance or it is less than the output impedance, in that case, this overall voltage gain will be less than the no load voltage gain. For example, for a 1 amplifier, if output impedance is 1 kilo ohm and the load resistance is 2 kilo ohm, in that case, the effective voltage gain will be equal to RL divided by RL plus Z0 times no load voltage gain. So in this case, it will be the 2/3 of the no load voltage gain. So in this way, this load resistance can also affect the overall voltage gain. And if we combine the effect of the source and the load resistance, then the overall voltage gain Vout divided by Vs can be given as Zin divided by Zin plus Rs times this no load voltage gain times RL divided by RL plus Z0, where this Zin and the Zout are the input and output impedance of this amplifier. So as you can see, because of the source and the load resistance, the effective voltage gain of the amplifier may get reduced. And in fact, this effect of the source and the load resistance will also be useful in our ongoing discussion on the multistage amplifier. So let us see how. So when we cascade the multiple amplifier stages, then ideally, the overall voltage gain will be the product of the individual voltage gain. That means in this case, it will be equal to AV1 times AV2 times AV3. But actually, each amplifier stage will act as a load to the previous amplifier stage. And because of this loading effect, the effective voltage gain will be less than the individual product of the voltage gains. And to understand it, let us take the example of the two amplifier stages. So here, the two amplifier stages are cascaded together, and here, the Zin1 and the Zout1 are the input and the output impedance of the first amplifier. Similarly, these Zin2 and the Zout2 are the input and output impedance of the second amplifier. So here, this second amplifier will act as a load for the first amplifier. And to be precise, this input impedance of this second amplifier will act as a load for the first amplifier. That means for the first amplifier, this RL is equal to Zin2. So let's say the input to the first amplifier, that is over here, is equal to Vin1. So we can say that the voltage Vout1 divided by Vin1 is equal to this AV1 times RL divided by RL plus Zout1, that is equal to AV1 times Zin2 divided by Zin2 plus Zo1. So this will be the effective voltage gain of the first amplifier. So now this voltage Vo1 will be the input for the second amplifier. That means here this Vo1 will be equal to Vin2. So similarly, now let us find the voltage gain of the second amplifier. That means now, this Vout2 divided by Vin2 will be equal to this AV2 times RL divided by RL plus Zout2. So this will be the effective voltage gain of the second amplifier. And let's call it as a AV2 effective. So if we see the overall voltage gain, that is Vout2 divided by Vin2, then it will be equal to AV1 effective times AV2 effective. Let's call this voltage gain as the AV effective. And to find the voltage gain, Vout2 divided by Vs, or effectively the Vout divided by Vs, we also need to take into account this series resistance. That means Vout divided by Vs will be equal to this AV effective times Zin1 divided by Zin1 plus Rs. So in this way, we can find the overall voltage gain of the multistage amplifier. So let us put some number into it and let us understand it through the example. So in this example, two identical common emitter amplifier stages are cascaded together. So here the source resistance is 100 ohm while the load resistance RL is equal to 2 kilo ohm. So for this multistage amplifier, let us find out the voltage gain Vout divided by Vs. And to find that, first of all, let us find the effective voltage gain of the first amplifier. So for the first stage, the input impedance of this second stage will act as a load impedance. That means here, this AV1 effective will be equal to AV1 times Zin2 divided by Zin2 plus Zout1. That is equal to 100 times 1 kilo ohm divided by 1 kilo ohm plus 2 kilo ohm. That is equal to 100 divided by 3. Similarly, let us find out the effective voltage gain of the second amplifier. So this AV2 effective will be equal to AV2 times RL divided by RL plus Zout2. That is equal to 100 times 2 kilo ohm divided by 2 kilo ohm plus 2 kilo ohm. That is equal to 50. So the overall voltage gain or the effective voltage gain AV effective will be equal to AV1 effective times AV2 effective. That is equal to 100 divided by 3 times 100 divided by 2. That is equal to 10 to the power 4 divided by 6, right? So this effective voltage gain represents the ratio of the Vout and the Vin1. But to find the Vout divided by Vs, we also need to take into account this series resistor. That means Vout divided by Vs can be given as this effective voltage gain times Zin1 divided by Zin1 plus Rs. That is equal to 10 to the power 4 divided by 6 times 1 kilo ohm divided by 1 kilo ohm plus 100 ohm. And if you calculate it, then this overall voltage gain will come out as 1515. So instead of getting the gain of 10,000, here we are getting the gain of around 1500. And that would even further reduce if this source resistor RS is in kilo ohm. For example, if this source impedance is 5 kilo ohm, then in that case, this overall voltage gain Vout divided by Vs will be equal to AV effective times 1 kilo ohm divided by 1 kilo ohm plus 5 kilo ohm. That is equal to 10 to the power 4 divided by 6 times 1 by 6. That is roughly equal to 278. So now if you see this voltage gain, then it is much less than the 10,000. So in such case, when the source impedance is high, then the common collector or the emitter follower can be used as a first stage for the impedance matching. Because if you remember, the emitter follower has a high input impedance and the low output impedance. So if we just add the common collector stage just before this common emitter stage, then we can prevent the reduction in the voltage gain. Similarly, if the load impedance is very low, then to drive such load, the emitter follower or the common collector can be used as a last stage. So depending on the source or the load impedance, the emitter follower can be used as a buffer at the beginning or at the end of the cascaded connection. But it is never used as a intermediate amplifiers, because the gain of this common collector amplifier is less than unity. Similarly, at the high frequencies, this common base amplifier can be used as a first stage for the impedance matching. But nevertheless, try to find the overall voltage gain of this multistage amplifier system once we add this emitter follower at the beginning. And do let me know your answer in the comment section. So before ending this video, this is the circuit of the two common emitter amplifiers which are cascaded together. So here, this is the first common emitter amplifier and this is the second one, and they are coupled through the capacitor. So I hope in this video you got an overview of the multistage amplifier and you understood how the multiple amplifiers can be cascaded together. So if you have any question or suggestion, do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.